Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel Home Aesthetics by Sauj, and this is Saujanya Kulkarni. In our previous video, we have seen an easy DIY of converting a vintage cabinet into a bookcase. If you have not watched that video, please click the link below in the description box. So, let's get started with the topic Tips on Designing Under Cabinets in Kitchen Part 2 based on my requirements. When space and budget are constraints, then we have to make wise decisions for which things we should choose pull-out systems. My kitchen is neither big nor small kitchen. It is a medium-sized kitchen which measures 8 feet by 9 feet. First, we have to make a list of two things. The first one, what things are we going to store in under cabinets? The second one, the things that are very frequently used while working in kitchen that are to be accessed from under cabinets. Both the points look same, but they are not. Let's see an example. This rice cooker, I will not use it on a daily basis, but I use it once in a week or 15 days once. So when I place it on kitchen platform, it is unnecessarily occupying space when not in use. So I decided to store this rice cooker in the bottom part of the under cabinets and take out when required. So by making list of things that are frequently used and rarely used things in kitchen, we can actually get a better idea where what can be placed and for which things we can actually opt pull-out systems. First, categorize the things that are based on usage, that is, daily used things, weekly once used or 15 days once used things, and monthly once used things. So, under the first category, that is daily used things in kitchen, we have spoons, ladles, knife, peeler, scissors, buttermilk churner and tea strainer. And then under the category of bowls, we have small, medium and large sized bowls. And under the category of plates, we have snacks, tiffin, dinner plates and then lids. And then we have pans, kadais and milk containers. And lastly, tea and drinking water glasses and small cups. So, for all these things, I have opted pull-out systems. Let's have a look in the kitchen. Immediately below the gas stove, I have provided cutlery basket, plain basket and thali basket. I have chosen perforated cutlery basket in my kitchen. In market, this model of cutlery basket is also available. Please don't opt for it. What happens is, because of these small gaps that are there in this design, at times small spoons and forks will hang on or drop to the bottom of the cabinet or onto the floor. Till now we have discussed about cutlery baskets, the different designs that are available in the market, and there are still n number of designs that are available in the market. You can choose according to your budget and requirement. So let's have a look of the cutlery basket now. Now, let's see the plain basket that is below the cutlery basket. All the small sized bowls are placed in this plain basket. Now, let's see the thali basket that is below the plain basket. All snack, tiffin and dinner plates along with some lids are placed in this thali basket. Now, let's see the bottle rack in which I have placed tea and drinking water glasses along with some small cups. Now, let's see the right side top plain basket which is besides the bottle rack. Here, I have placed medium and large sized bowls, milk containers and kadais. Till now, we have seen the first category of things that are used on a daily basis. Now, let's see the second category of things that are used weekly once or 15 days once. Now, let's see under the second category, that is weekly or 15 days once used things in kitchen. We have rice cooker, wet grinder, non-stick pans, idli container, empty tiffin boxes, Tupperware boxes and steel boxes. Now, let's have a look in the kitchen. Here, right side bottom cabinet, I have chosen a plain basket in which I have placed wet grinder and electrical rice cooker. Here, I have opted for carousel design. As the depth of the cabinet is too deep, I cannot access the things if I go ahead with shelf system. This carousel system basically has a central rod to which two steel baskets are fixed. We can actually rotate these steel basket and access the things in 360 degrees angle. Now, let's move on to the left side of the kitchen where we have three cabinets. Here, we have corner cabinet which is a shelf system. The corner cabinet is divided into two divisions. In the topmost division, I have kept all the different types of pans which I use them occasionally. In the bottom cabinet, I have placed idli container, cooker, puri presser and few more things which are occasionally used. Now, let's move on to the next cabinet, that is detergent cabinet. Here, I have a dustbin basket and a pull-out steel basket. Wantedly, I did not put dustbin in the dustbin rack because I thought over a period of time, smell will be developed. Rather, I have used it to store Surf, Sabina and other things in the basket. In this basket, I have stored paste, soap, Rin bars, Vim bars, toilet cleaning liquids, Colin and other things. We can actually slide this basket and pick the things whatever are required from it. Now, let's move on to the next category of usage, that is monthly once used items. Likewise, I have only one cabinet in my kitchen which I use very rarely, and that is pickles cabinet. So, all these things we have to keep in our mind when we are designing under cabinets in kitchen. Hope you liked today's video. Please like, share, subscribe, comment and don't forget to press bell icon which will give you updates on whatever I post on YouTube. So, see you in my next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.